you have second and third graders, this is okay. If you have high school girls, when we do bitty ball, this is where we start bitty ball, right? So I'll likely be in charge of bitty ball again this year, which is awesome. But again, if we start here, the thing is that you're not going to have as many people in the gym, obviously, right? But you want to have the ball in their hand as much as humanly possible. So let's say you have 12 girls at practice. You've got two teams practicing, and both teams got six, right? You can go 12 lines, right? 12 lines. You don't have to go one person on every single person in the ball. So one of the big philosophies that you want to deal with here, keep the ball in every girl's hand as much as humanly possible, okay? So that's the first thing. If you look at my sheet, which you don't have right now, but I put it on there, for each one of these drills, there are details, right? The details is really the important part. So you haven't wanted to get the big idea of the drill, but you can work on so many little things with every single drill that will really, really help you actually put this all together. There's nothing more overwhelming than feeling like you ran a really good practice, and then you like spend the last 5 minutes, 10 minutes at the end, and you let them scrimmage a little bit, and you're like, whoa, that was really, really bad. We look great. And you think to yourself, man, we need so much work on like everything. So don't be discouraged, but also let that discouragement from the last 10 minutes of practice inform what you do at your next practice, because then you look at yourself and you're like, all right, well, I had three girls catch the ball here and just go, like it's a happy day. All right, well, I gotta work on it. Right, so you can kind of inform what you should do next by how horribly you look at the ISO play your first weekend, or how horribly you look, when you guys go scrimmage, right? First thing, ready? We call these speed dribbles, sometimes we'll call them swimmer speed dribbles, these are like Michael Phelps's. But right, the detail is, I want them to start here. I want them to start here every time. Like, you know, triple threat position, triple attack position. So if you have them roll the ball themselves, they sell it here, we don't sell it for right now. Get the ball by your left ear. If you get it up by your left ear, then you're in a good spot. Because you're gonna step with your right foot and you're gonna do it with your right hand. So your first, that first dribble will be here. So here's all I'm gonna do, ready? I'm just gonna go here, right, left, right, left, jump stop, come back, right, left, jump stop, give it to the next person, all right? Nice and easy, hey, get it here, rip it through, and go, all right, ready?
We're on camera.
Go. Toss to yourself, step in. Now get low. Ready? From here, you're going to rip it through from your left ear to right above your right shoulder. Dribble, and then you make your dribble right, left, right, left. If you're comfortable going a little faster, go a little faster because that's what we'll do. All right, this is just a warm up, so we're trying to get them up to speed and get their blood flowing. So look, I toss to myself, I step in, boom, I go right. Jump stop. Now look, what the girls will do is this, right? You tell them to jump stop, and they'll go. What I do sometimes in a press, I'll go. You just shout it. Shout it. And they're like, what? When you jump stop on the line there, shout it. They're looking like, that means that we just lost the ball. So look, you get here. Jump stop. Pick it. Again, ready? Give it to the next person. Ready? Same thing. Nice and barn. Let's go.
Thank you.
is like 10 minutes. All right, next thing. All right, you're gonna start the same way you did before. Right here, you're gonna get to midcourt. Boom. Stop. We'll start. We'll go left foot, front pivot, pivot. Go again. Right hand. Stop. Pivot. So look, your left foot stays. Your left foot stays. I can hear. Bend those knees. Who has an ACL? Go up, go up, top. My ACL looks good. Gripping head. So look, here's what we want them. Low. Watch when we pivot. Ready? It's not this. The girls will do this. Ready? Pivot. Pivot. And then I go again.
And watch the girls while they're watching you do it. If you come to camp, the best part is watching the girls in line and then watching you guys. When you say, if you say left foot front pivot and you go like this, you'll see the girls in line. They're like. So if one coach is here, have the other coach stand somewhere around the baseline and watch the girls do it. You'll see the girl in the back, she's probably the most nervous about this stroke. She's not in the front. She's kind of hanging out here and you'll see her. She's like, what? Find that girl and help her. Tell her there's a nail in her foot. Trust me, it gets a little scared the first time, but tell her that she can't pick that foot up, but she can spin it. Okay, so one of the benefits of having a lot of coaches in the room is that you all don't have to be standing out here. One person can be here in the crowd, and they can see what girl is pivoting on her wrong foot just in practice. You can nip that in the bud before she gets even out there.
All right, ready? We're going to go. Again, start everything here. Just remind them, start everything here. Nice and low by their left ear. Reach out, right hand. Don't stop. Left toe stays. Good. Look. I'm ready to throw elbows. And then go again. Ready? Go.
Good. Last foot, front pivot. Good. Hey, Jay Johnson, you better get that right every time. You better get it right every time. You travel there, AJ.
One bar left, huh?
How long do you do that for?
Right, took the battery on.
We gotta stop worrying about it.
I say the first time you practice it,
an hour?
It's not gonna be pretty.
Yeah.
But hasn't been an hour.
You don't have to stay with it.
No.
A little bit over now.
You can look at the other
perspective.
All right, they saw it, they heard it. You're not gonna practice it tonight.
You know what I'm saying?
But we're gonna do this every time that we come here, right? So the next time you go, all right, start by your right ear. You hit your left hand. Right foot,
front
pivot.
Buy a new balance.
We're not going to do that, but that's like the natural progression of things. If you have older girls, the older girls are going to start to add reverse pivots. Left foot, reverse pivot. Reverse pivot. All right. That's probably not necessary if you're coaching second and third grade girls. But once you get to fourth and fifth grade, the girls have this idea that if there's a defender on their back, that they're in a bad spot. It's quite the opposite. Defender on your back. You really want to go by, it's one of the best things that can happen to you. So we won't go through the whole progression, but that's the whole progression. Again, it's on the YouTube page. This whole thing's on the YouTube page. Next thing we'll do for the side, we're going to go glide, retreat, attack. Now, here's the thing, right? This is a more complicated thing that you may say, like, all right, looks like a second and third grade. There's no chance. Hey, if you do this every practice, by the end of it, your second and third graders will do this. Glide, they'll retreat, they'll attack. Maybe not like that, but they will. They'll glide, they'll retreat, and they'll attack. Right? So, but if you do it every time, 10 minutes, they'll do it. So watch, ready? You're gonna glide. When I blow the whistle, you're gonna retreat. When I blow the whistle a second time, like this, you're gonna attack, right? I'll show you. I'll say go. Glide. Retreat. sit. You don't have to sit. You can cross over and go. You can go here and go. Go.